Rev Up to Excel 2010, Chapter 7, Custom Margins. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Chapter 7 of the Rev Up to Excel 2010 book talks about page layout view. But in this episode of the podcast, I'm not going to cover that. I think we've covered that before for the other books. I want to talk about when you're setting custom margins, specifically, your favorite margins. Every single time that I have a new workbook, let's just do Control N, I go into the page setup, I go back to the margins tab, and these margins, these default margins, are always too wide. I'm trying to fit as much data as I can going across the spreadsheet, so I always go to a quarter of an inch on the left and the right. I'm sure it's wrong according to my high school English teacher, but I put a quarter of an inch margin at the top. On the bottom, I reluctantly go to half an inch because I need the footer to be at a quarter of an inch, and those are my favorite margins every single time. I find that I always do that, use the Dialog launcher, and go in and do that. Well, hey, I'm going to encourage you to avoid the Dialog launcher in this particular case, because what I'm going to suggest is that after you have created those favorite margins, and those are the margins you use all the time, the next time you have a spreadsheet, I'll just do Control N again to get another workbook here. You can go into that margins dropdown, and where they used to offer normal, wide, and narrow, they now offer last custom setting, and check that out. It's all of the settings that I had previously. Choose that and we're good to go. We don't have to go through and visit the page setup dialog anymore. Two click access to your favorite. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.